Good morning. Yes, I'm bundled up again. For a couple of days, we thought we were warming up here in Sacramento. But it was in the 30s, the mid 30s in our backyard this morning. I just can't get warm. I'm back from my walk. Excuse my being bundled up again. It seems like it's been 9 months. But I guess I have to thank my lucky stars because last year at this time it was starting to get terribly hot. And right here in our neighborhood, last year we had at least 5 straight days where it was over 120 in our backyard. So I'm not complaining that much. I'm in a goofy mood today. As you know, I'm sort of writing a with my friend Jim Brickowski, and Wynn Myers, working on a screenplay to resurrect the Crowley novel. That was a screenplay that was turned into a novel to be turned into a screenplay, and who knows where that's going, but we're having fun playing with it anyway, once again. I got out my old copy of Equinox Volume 1, Number 6, okay, which has the rites of Eleusis in it, and other fun things. Because I wanted to share with you an essay by Francis Bendick this morning. The mysterious character Francis Bendick, and I posted a little something today about that. Today we'll just read his essay. But going through it, I remember that that the Equinox, the Method of Science, Aim of Religion, that was published by Crowley over a 5-year period. Every Equinox had come out with another installment. It was like a heroic magazine. This is a 1972 edition. It may look older, because I beat it up so badly, especially during the years we were producing the Rites of Eleusis. There's my old stamp in it with my old magical motto, Adeosat Beni, which is corrupt Latin for so far so good. But I was reminded that the Equinox was sort of like a glorified magazine. It even had ads, ads for Crowley's stuff. There's his ads for the winged beetle and Victor Newberg's Triumph of Pan. I mean, where else are they? There wasn't a TV or anything to occult publications, Fuller's Star in the West. And I think even in the back, if I'm not mistaken, there's more stuff, more ads. Goetia, New Thought Library, even an ad for the robe maker, for the AA robe maker, and with prices for the different different official robes. anyway, and there was a pronouncement here. This page reserved for official pronouncements by the Chancellor of the AA. Persons wishing for information, assistance, further interpretation, etc., are requested to communicate with the Chancellor of the AA, care of the Equinox, 3 Great James Street, WC. Telephone, City 8987. You could call them in 19, whatever this is, 1912 or 13. Or to call at that address by appointment. A representative will be there to meet them. Probationers are reminded that the object of probations and ordeals is one, namely, to select adepts. But the method appears twofold. One, to fortify the fit. Two, to eliminate the unfit. The Chancellor of the AA views without satisfaction the practice of probationers working together. A probationer should work with his neophyte or alone. Breach of this rule may prove a bar to advancement. Anyway, so that's that. I found other goodies tucked away in this particular book from my library. This is a commentary on the rite of Jupiter that was found among Gerald York's. This isn't the original, I'm sure, among Gerald York's collection of things. I'm not sure how it came into my possession, but it's just a copy, whatever it is. It's a typewritten thing about with little goodies like that, suggesting how the stage layout should be. And yeah, this is from Gerald York's manuscript book number one. I got 5 pages of stuff like that. And that was helpful when we were starting to actually produce the rites in our living room, in our backyard, and later on in the woods and deserts of Southern California. Anyway, I'm going to read something by Francis Bendick, and that we use this in our 8th homemade rite of Eleusis, that we would finish off our series of the Crowley's 7 planetary rites of Eleusis. We'd do a yearly cycle, go through all 7. And then we'd finish off the series with a homemade rite of Earth, because you come down from Saturn, Jupiter, Mars, Sol, Venus, Mercury, Luna, and then the Earth for number 10. And so we'd seal off the yearly rites of Eleusis series with the rite of Earth, which was constructed sort of a retelling of the rite of Demeter, the rite of Persephone. And the Jameses at the then 93 Lodge really took that rite of Persephone ball and ran with it big time, and did that every year out, sort of using what we threw together with our rite of Earth. and dilated it and made it a beautiful, beautiful thing. And everybody laments the fact that that's not going anymore. But anyway, toward the end of the rite of Earth, we ended up sort of tearing a page out of the format of the other rites of Eleusis, inserting certain poetry from other sources. And one of the finale of the rite of Earth, we utilized this essay, if you will, from Francis Bendick of the from the Equinox. So here it is. The child of miracle to the world, greeting. I reach my hands to the leaves and dabble in the dew. I sprinkle dew on you for kisses. I kneel down and hold the grass of the black earth to my bosom. I crush the earth to my lips as if it were a grape. And the wine of Demeter flushes my cheeks. They burn with joy of youth. Why should I greet the world? Because my heart is bursting with love for the world. Love, I say? Why not lust? Is not lust strength and merriment, and the famine that only the infinite can stay? And why do I call myself the child of miracle? Because I have entered a second time into my mother's womb and am born. Because to the knowledge of manhood has come the passion, even the folly of adolescence, with all its pride and purity. It is for this that you see me lying on the thick, wet grass, unquenchable, or rejoicing in the fat, black loam. Now, the manner of the miracle was this. In the beginning is given to a youth the vision of his mate. This one must he henceforth seek blindly, and many are the enchantments and disenchantments. Through this his vision fades, even his hunger dies away unless he be indeed elect. But in the end, it may be that God shall send him the other half of that token of paradise. Then, if he have kept the holy fire alight, perhaps with much false fuel, that fire shall instantly blaze and fill the temple of his soul. But its insistent energy, excuse me, by its insistent energy, it shall destroy even the memory of all those marsh lights that came to greet it. And the priest shall bow down in the glory and grasp the altar with his hands and strike it with his forehead 7 times. Now, this altar is the earthen altar of Demeter. Then, understanding all things by the light of that love, he shall know that this is love, and this is the soul of the earth, that this is the fertility and understanding, the secret of Demeter. Nay, even the oracle may speak in his heart and foretell or foreshadow the great mysteries of Persephone, of death, the daughter of love. So too, who are thus reborn will understand that I, who write these words, am stretched out on the wet earth on the day of spring, It is night, but only the sea whispers of Persephone as the stars intimate Urania, whose mystery is the third and beyond. My body is absorbed in scent and touch, for the consuming fire of my sight has burnt itself out to blindness, and in my mouth is only the savor of an infinite kiss. The moist earth burns my lips. My fingers search down about the roots of the grass. The life of earth itself is my life. I shall be glad to be buried in the earth. Let my body dissolve into hers, putrefying in her reviving limbic. He never loved who let them case him in a coffin from the supreme embrace. It is from the earth, bride of the sun, that all bodily strength derives. It is no figure that Entius regained all his force when he touched earth. And it is no pedantry and folly of the Hindus who, fearing bodily lust, isolate their acolytes from earth. No futility, their doctrine of prana and of tamoguna. It is not mere faith, healing, that is hygiene of Father Knepp, and his failures are those who retain decorum and melancholy, who follow the letter and not the spirit, cold-blooded treaders upon the earth instead of passionate lovers of its strength. It is no accident of mythology that the Titans made war upon the gods and in Prometheus overthrew them. It was when Canute failed to drive back the sea that his dynasty was lost to that Norman William who caught hold of Mother Earth with both hands. When I was a child, I fell, and the scars of the earth are on my forehead at this hour. When I was a boy, I was hurt by the explosion of a buried jar of gunpowder. The scars of the earth are on my face at this hour. Since then, I've been the lover of the earth that wooed me thus roughly. Many a night I've slept upon her naked breast in forest and on glacier, upon plains and upon lonely crags, in heat and cold, fair weather and foul. And my blood is the blood of the earth. My life is hers, and she is a spark thrown off from the whirling brilliance of the sun. So do I know myself to be a spark of infinite God. Seek earth, and heaven shall be added unto you. Back to our mother. Drive the shining spade into her womb. Wrinkle her with your furrow. She will only smile more kindly. Let your sweat, the sweat of your toil, which is your passion, drip like benediction from on high upon her. She will render corn and wine. Also, your wife shall be desirable in your eyes all the days of your life, and your children shall be strong and comely, and the blessing of the Most High shall be upon you. Then let your grasp relax in the satiety of death, and your weight shall cumber the earth. And the little children of the earth shall make merry with you until the rose strike its root into your breast. Then shall your body be one again with the mother, and your soul one with the father, as it is written in the book of the law. All this I have been taught by her, whose purity and strength are even as earth's, chosen before the foundation of time. Lioness with lion, may we walk by night among the ruins of great cities, when weary with happiness too great even for our immortality, we turn from the fragrance and fertility of earth. And at sunrise, return where the peopled valleys call us, where bronze and buoyant our children sing aloud as they drive home the spade. Glory be to the earth, and to the sun, and to the holy body and soul of man. And glory be to love, and to the Father of love, the secret unity of things. Glory be to the shrine within the temple, and to the God within the shrine, to the Word and to the silence that bore it unto him that is beyond the silence in the speech. And thanksgiving in the highest for the gift of all these things, for the maiden in whom all these things are found, for the holy body and soul of man, and for the sun, and for the earth. Amen. Francis Bendick. And that's it for today. I hope you are enjoying your week so far. And I hope to see you tomorrow. Continue to be good to yourself, be good to each other, be good to the earth. Do what thou wilt shall be the whole of the law. Love is the law. Love under will.